Roshan Mathew, a huge welcome to Bollywood Life. Pleasure speaking to you. One good thing about this lockdown and the OTT boom that films are coming on it is that Bollywood media is getting to interact with some top actors from the South industry. So we are really fortunate to do that. So that's one good thing.
Thank you. Thank you. That's very kind of you. Thank you.
Roshan, you've had a pretty exciting, interesting career till now. There has been Kude. Please correct me if my pronunciation is wrong over here.
No, you're fine. Been, you're fine.
Kapela, if I'm not mistaken, there has been Matchbox, Pirutham Niyamam.
Pudhiya Niyamam.
Yes, that's one of your first big films. And now comes See You Soon. What is it? Is it A, you have a knack for choosing projects that, you know, will just has something unique to offer the audience, or do they just come to you?
It's a bit of both. I think I've mostly been really lucky with projects like See You Soon and Mooton. With the ones like Kude, Kude is a movie that I went after, that I kept calling the director about. I kept insisting, asking her to give me an audition. So that's how that one happened. See You Soon was a call that came to me one of the lockdown evenings where Fahad said, we're doing something, it might be interesting, you want to be part of it. So it literally came to me. So there's been a bit of both. But on the whole, I have been lucky to associate with some great people and be part of some really interesting projects.
When I've seen See You Soon, there has been a web series that recently came, The Gone Game. I'm not sure whether you have managed to catch it or not.
I think I watched the trailer.
Yes, so this was that also lockdown themed shot, what they call nowadays these desktop films. It is starting to grow.
Yeah, so
that was also lockdown theme, but it was partially. A lot of times the actors were normally in the frame. This is looking a lot more like that, like we saw Searching. There was a Searching with John Cho. This is looking a lot more like that, and also a movie called Unfriended, which came a few years ago. Mm-hmm. Did the inspiration come from there, from Searching or John Cho? Obviously, the story will be different. Or B, was the inspiration, the lockdown was the inspiration, and how people are communicating during this time?
Yeah, no, I'm fairly certain that the inspiration did come from Searching, because that was one of the first things that was mentioned when we sat down for our initial script reading. Mahesh San and the director sort of went around asking if everybody had watched Searching, and I'd watched it in the theater when it played. So it is based on the language that Searching put forward, but this is also an evolution on that language. There's something that Mahesh San has added from his side, which is which is really cool, the virtual cinematography part of it. So we are using that language, but we're also taking it forward, I think. And that's got to be the exciting part about the film. And as far as the story goes, that's the thing, right? The movie can't be about the format. That can't be what steals the attention. So at the end of the day, with See You Soon, at least when I watch the film, what works for me is the fact that after a while, you get used to the format and you forget about it. And then all you're following is the story and the characters in the story. So that's when the language really works, because it is a story that lends itself to this sort of a format.
Was it initially intended to be a theatrical release, or was it always meant for OTT platform?
So initially, when I first got the call about it, I don't know what the discussions were before it, but when I first got the call about it, there was no plan. The idea was just to go ahead and make the film. So we have something to do. So there is some sort of creation happening. And most importantly, there are people who will be employed by the project who will have a source of income when that has been stuck for a period of time. And then what Fahad said is, we'll figure out what is a way to put it out to the audience. There was always the assurance that it will reach an audience. We just had no clarity on what the medium would be. It was only after the movie was finished that we decided Amazon came on board.
Do you think so it is more suited to an OTT platform, but now that it's coming on it?
I don't know. I've honestly, when the discussions initially were happening about all possible mediums, I was very intrigued about how this movie would look on a big screen in a theater. And because I very clearly remember my experience of watching Searching, and because of what's different about this one from that language, I still don't have an answer to that because I still haven't seen it on a big screen. Obviously, it fits right in to an OTT platform, right? Whether you're watching it on your phone or on your laptop or your desktop, your TV, it fits right in. It is very relatable. It is very familiar. But yeah, I would be curious to know what it looks like on a big screen.
Okay, when I first seen you and Fahad interact in the trailer, I was the one question that kept coming to your mind is, what is the relation between you all in the film?
My cousin brother.
He's your cousin brother. Okay, yeah. He's your cousin brother. Okay, so that was a very interesting thing. I must say that Malayalam cinema in general has always been about breaking new ground in Indian cinema as a whole, and the audience has been more reciprocative to it, right? I mean, whether it be thrillers,
yeah,
very different from the other mainstream cinema.
Yeah, we've been lucky that way to have an extremely receptive audience that is always willing to go out there, buy a ticket to, and give a shot to the movie that's playing, you know. It is obviously an industry that still has its sure shots on one side. You know that, you know, if a movie with a superstar comes out, then obviously there are some things that you can take for granted. But even for movies on the other side of it, movies that are extremely experimental, that have new faces in it, new directors or new crew members or entirely new teams all together, there's still a segment of the audience that is willing to give it a shot. And I think that's what's keeping the experiments going, because people are willing to try out new things because they know that somewhere in there is a certain segment of the audience that the movie will work for. And if we do it well enough, if we make it genuinely enough, we might still, you know, break even or have a good run with it.
Malayalam audience is amazing, right? I mean, now the audience is becoming more diverse because, yeah, the advent of how the industry is emerging. But the Malayalam audience is amazing, right? Because you mentioned the thing when a superstar comes and you're like, you know, you're going to get an opening or something. But they have been reciprocative to that films. They have been reciprocative to films where a superstar comes in a movie like Drishyam, which is quite different.
Yeah. Yeah.
Also would generally do. Okay. Yeah. So that's quite different. And also they are not concerned. Would you say that they are not Malayalam audience is one audience that is not concerned with what happens to social media? Is like they're impervious on it. They are just concerned with what comes in the cinema, what comes in on an OTT platform. And they are concerned with that content. They don't care whether it's a superstar, a star kid. They just care about the content.
Yeah, in a lot of ways, things have been heading in the more content-driven direction over here. And I'm also somebody who believes, and I think for that matter, I would like to believe that whatever happens around it on social media or, you know, on page 3 doesn't really impact things as much as it does in the other industries in the country. I don't know how much of it is just me wanting to believe it and how much of it is actually true. But that's what I have felt. And yeah, and it's also, I guess we have been, as an industry, trying and testing the audience regularly, including these, you know, superstars, people like Mammootty and Mohanlal who've been around. Now, you named Drishyam. There was a movie called Unda that came out last year with Mammootty in it. It's so different from everything else that we've seen him in. So it starts at the top, right? They also start experimenting and they're also exposing their regular audience to something new, something different whenever they get a chance to. Everyone's excited about trying new things and finding out an original, different way of doing the thing that we have all been doing. So I think in a way the audience have been receptive and the industry has also not let them be settled and be comfortable with one sort of thing. We have constantly been coming up with different things to feed the audience, and I think that's also very important.
And how do you think so the reverence or the acceptance of other industries has evolved? Like when initially in the 90s and early 2000s, when Mohanlal sir was doing Bollywood, he never got a lead role in Ram Gopal Varma movies, though he got very meaty parts. But now when you see you got a lead role in Choked, Dulkar has got a lead role in Zoya Factor and Carvaan Parallel Trade. So now you think so? Also, other industries don't see all as South imports. They used to call them in the Hindi industry South imports, but they just see all as actors doing a part who can play a lead role in a Hindi film also.
Yeah, I feel like a lot of the lines that we used to have been blurring, and even in terms of the audience, a lot of Malayalam cinema is now reaching a non-Malayalam speaking audience. So in that way, with that sort of exposure and with the sort of connected lives that we're all living, I feel like it is only a matter of time before the boundaries really start blurring, and that is definitely a good thing. There should always be migration of artists between these different industries, and there should be more collaborations happening. It could lead to some really exciting projects, I think. So I, for one, I'm looking forward to that very much.
Okay. See you soon. How was it shot? That's what I would really like to know.
So we used iPhone cameras, we used a Panasonic DSLR, we used a GoPro at some point in time. These were the three equipments that we used, and it was a very minimal crew, including the actors. I guess it must have been like 12 to 14 people max. We all moved into the same building, four different apartments in the same building, and mostly within the spaces where we were living in that building is where majority of the film was shot. There were a few locations outside, but yeah, it was very, very minimal and hardly any setup at all. You know, everything was like, it was jugaad all the way. And that is what sort of gave us the luxury to really try and take our time with things and, you know, spend as much time as we needed on a particular scene or a particular shot, because you need that luxury with something like this. It's so different from everything that we've done before that we're all discovering what the way to do this is, and that the fact that we had such a small, meager setup really gave us that luxury that we needed.
इसमें cinematographer का क्या शराय
नहीं नहीं हिंदी ठीक है चलता है
इसमें cinematographer का क्या काम है is it a work slash completely
नहीं नहीं दो तरह की सिनेमेटोग्राफी है इसमें एक तो इज द कन्वेंशनल सिनेमेटोग्राफी वेयर द वर्क वाज मिनिमल जहाँ पे समझो कि एक आईफोन है जिसको एक फ्रेम पे लगाया गया है और मैं फ्रेम पकड़ रहा हूँ एक साइड से बट वी आर शूटिंग विद द बैक कैमरा ऑफ द आईफोन राइट तो मुझे दिख नहीं रहा कि फ्रेम एक्चुअली क्या है कि मैं कैसे फ्रेम कर रहा हूँ अपने आप को सो द सिनेमेटोग्राफर ऑन द अदर साइड ऑफ दिस ही इज द वन हु कैन सी द फ्रेम ऑफ द कैमरा उसने दूसरी तरफ से ये frame pakda hai and whenever he wants to adjust it a little bit he can pull it push it lift it whatever as long as I'm holding it softly enough that is possible and then obviously how to you know where to position the conversation light kahan se aani kitni light aani ye sab it's all up to the cinematographer the virtual cinematography part of it which Mahesh Narayanan did the director did is where the camera goes within the screen that you are watching on your screen so on your TV or on your laptop or wherever the camera still moves and zooms in and pans and zooms out and everything so that is something that happened in post during edit so that part of it was done by Mahesh Narayanan obviously the cinematographer was also around for it
और इसमें आर्टिफिशियल लाइटिंग यूज होता है और यू ऑल रिलाय कंप्लीटली ऑन द लाइटिंग ऑफ द फोन
नहीं मतलब वेरी मिनिमल ऐसा नहीं कि लाइट्स रेंट किए गए थे so we're shooting in a room and mostly using lights in the room there's a certain amount of light that falls on your face from the phone itself when you're on a video call so when you're using the back of the phone the back camera of the phone that has to be compensated from outside So then that's like again, very tiny jugaad setup or like a lot of white tape and everything.
Okay, last two questions. Now we have spoken about the cinematography, obviously. B, I would like to know, does this format of shooting, aapka kaam acting hai, but obviously a part of the creative process also. Does this format of shooting make an editor's life easier or more difficult?
You should really ask the director this, who is also the editor of the film. And he's such a brilliant editor. He's been working as an editor for ages. So I really don't know. The fact is, I know that it must have been a huge advantage that he was directing it and editing it himself. And he is someone who shoots with his edit in mind. there is, you can feel that kind of clarity when he's directing you, when you're doing the sequences. So if it were him working with an editor from the outside, I don't know how different it would have been. But yeah, this really is a question that you should ask him.
Okay, I will definitely, and I will tell that you told me to ask him also.
Yeah, please
and
do.
Final question, besides your work in Malayalam cinema, is there any more offers coming from Bollywood to you? And is there anybody in Bollywood you would like to work with?
Yeah, obviously there are a lot of people that I want to work with. There's a lot of people whose work I've seen. And even before Choked happened, I've been really impressed with it. It's obviously after that film that I felt like, that I felt that it is accessible. But yeah, there are people that I would love to work with. There are projects being discussed, but mostly because of the current situation and everything, nothing's finalized enough for me to be able to tell you.
Okay.
But yeah.
It was lovely talking to you. Like I said, wouldn't get this chance otherwise if it wasn't for this lockdown. So one good thing about that. Amazing talking to you, Roshan. And I hope to see such amazing work from you and you taking these lovely risks and satisfying us as both as a critic and as an audience. So thank you for that.
Thank you. Thank you. That's very sweet. Thank you. I hope you enjoy the film.
Yes, I'm sure I would. Yeah. Pleasure. Bye-bye.
Yeah.
Thank you, Russell. Thank you.